हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर मैट्रिक्स। यू मे गेट शॉर्ट नोट फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक ऑन कोलेजन और कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर मैट्रिक्स विद देयर फंक्शंस एंड डिसऑर्डर्स रिलेटेड विद एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर मैट्रिक्स। विल डिस्कस अबाउट द डेफिनेशन, वेरियस कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर मैट्रिक्स, देयर फंक्शंस एंड डिसऑर्डर्स रिलेटेड विद देम। In definition, what is the meaning of extracellular matrix? Extracellular matrix, it is a gel-like substance present in extracellular space. It is also known as ground substance or also known as connective tissue. Now, what are the various components of extracellular matrix? It is divided into three types, that is structural proteins. Second one is the specialized glycoproteins and third one is the proteoglycans. Structural proteins, specialized glycoproteins and proteoglycans. Now, what is difference between these glycoprotein and proteoglycans? The carbohydrate content in glycoprotein is less, while in proteoglycan carbohydrate content can extend up to 95% of total weight. And it is mainly glycosaminoglycans. This is the difference between glycoprotein and proteoglycan. Now, these are the various structural proteins or fibrous proteins, that is collagen, elastin, fibrillin. Collagen, it is a most abundant protein found in animals. Then elastin, it is present in elastic tissues, for example lung. It is responsible for elasticity of lung, elasticity of blood vessels, elasticity of tendons. Okay, so collagen, elastin and fibrillin, these are the structural fibrous proteins. Then specialized glycoproteins are fibronectin and laminin, and various proteoglycans, these are agrican, perlican, syndecan, sirglycine, decorin, fibromodulin, beta-glycan, these are the various proteoglycans. And various glycosaminoglycans, they are responsible for this formation of proteoglycans. This includes hyaluronic acid, chondroitin sulfate, dermatan sulfate, keratin sulfate, heparin sulfate and heparin. These are the various glycosaminoglycans which are involved in the formation of extracellular matrix. So, these are the components of extracellular matrix. Okay. Now, we'll discuss one by one component with their functions. The first one is the collagen. Collagen, it is a most abundant protein found in animals. It is coming to the discussion of collagen. You may get short note on this. It is a most abundant protein found in animals. And it is a triple helix. Triple helix. Composed of polypeptide chain, with each polypeptide chain having 1000 amino acids. 1000 amino acids in each polypeptide chain. It is a triple helix composed of repeating unit of glycine X and Y. This is glycine. It is a most abundant amino acid in collagen. Constitute about 30% weight of collagen. Glycine is the most abundant, followed by proline, hydroxyproline, then lysine. It is formed from pre-procollagen. Now coming to the synthesis of collagen. So in collagen synthesis, PPTC means first there is pre-procollagen. Suppose this is pre-procollagen with signal peptide. This is a signal peptide, the carboxy terminal. Okay, this is the signal peptide in pre-procollagen. Pre-procollagen. With the action of signal peptidase, this signal sequence is cleaved up. Okay, results in formation of, this is result in formation of procollagen. This is procollagen with carboxyl terminal and amino terminal. Now it undergoes post-translational modification in the form of hydroxylation glycosylation formation of disulfide linkage in and formation of triple helix. It is converted into tropocollagen. It is converted into tropocollagen with this amino and carboxyl terminal. It is known as tropocollagen. Now this tropocollagen, by the action of amino propeptidase and carboxy propeptidase, by cleaving up this amino terminal and carboxyl terminal, it is converted into collagen. And with formation of collagen crosslinks, so there is action of propeptidase and crosslinks with the formation of hydroxylysin, it is converted into collagen. So these are the steps in the synthesis of collagen: pre-procollagen, procollagen, tropocollagen and collagen. These are the steps in the synthesis of collagen. Okay, so it is most abundant triple helix, each polypeptide chain composed of 1000 amino acid, mainly glycine contributes to the collagen. 30% weight is due to glycine. Other common amino acids are proline, hydroxyproline, lysine. Okay, and form through these steps. Now what is importance of collagen? It is present in various tissues, and there are near about 19 different types of collagen. How many types of collagen? 19 different types of collagen. Of these first four, they are more common, that is type 1, type 2, type 3 and type 4 collagen. Type 1, 2, 3, 4, they are represented by Roman numerals. Okay, so how many types of collagen are there? There are total 19 types of collagen. They are represented by Roman numerals. Likewise, type 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the more common collagen and constitute about 95% of collagen. Type 1, 2, 3, 4. Total how many types? Up to 19. Okay, so this type 1, it is present in bones. Mainly it is present in bones. Type 2, it is in cartilage. Type 3, it is present in elastic tissue, for example, lung, blood vessels, and tendons. And type 4, it is present in the glomerular basement membrane. It is present in the lamina of glomerular basement membrane. Okay, so these are the four main types of collagen. And according to the structure they form, they are again divided into various types. For example, the first one is the, this is type according to their source. There are total 19 types as mentioned in this table, total 19 types of collagen. And according to structure they form, they are divided into fibril forming collagen. Second one is the network like collagen. Third one is the facets, that is fibril associated collagen interrupted transmembrane. So facets. Then fourth one is the beaded like collagen. Then fifth one is the anchoring fibrils. Sixth one is the transmembrane. And seventh one is the others. Okay, so these are the types according to structure they form. Fibril forming, network like, facets, beaded appearance, anchoring fibrils, transmembrane and others. These are the different types of collagen. Now, what are the various diseases which are related with this collagen formation? They are arises from the different genes. There arises from the many genes, and there are more number of post-translational modifications and number of enzymes are there. So it is related with the various disorders. The first one is the disorders related with collagen. The first important disorder is osteogenesis imperfecta. This is a bone disease. It is due to defective gene or mutation in the gene of type 1 collagen. Osteogenesis imperfecta. Bone disease due to defect in type 1 collagen results in formation of brittle bones. Then other symptoms are deafness, blue sclera, osteogenesis imperfecta due to defect in type 1 collagen. Second one is the Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. Various types are there. Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. It is due to mutation in the gene coding for type 1 and type 3 collagen, and also there may be defect in lysyl hydroxylase. Hydroxylase defect. Okay, that results in Ehlers-Danlos syndrome characterized by hypermobility of joints and hyperextensibility of fingers. Okay, hypermobility of joints and hyperextensibility of finger. Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. Okay, and third one is the Alport syndrome. It is due to defect in gene coding for type 4 collagen, that is laminin. Okay, it is due to the defect in the gene which code for type 4 collagen, and it is characterized by hematuria and renal failure. Hematuria and renal failure. Now, fourth one is Menkes disease. Menkes disease, it is due to deficiency of lysyl hydroxylase. Deficiency of lysyl hydroxylase due to defective copper absorption. Due to copper deficiency, there is deficiency of lysyl hydroxylase, which results in the kinky hair and skeletal deformities and neurodegeneration in Menkes disease. Neurodegeneration, skeletal deformities, and kinky hair. Menkes disease. Okay, now fifth one is the scurvy. Scurvy, it is due to deficiency of ascorbic acid, which affect the hydroxylation process. Hydroxylation of proline and lysine is affected, that's why it affect the collagen cross linking, and capillary fragility is there, that's why there is hemorrhagic tendencies in the scurvy, and bleeding gums are there. Okay, due to defective collagen cross linking, due to defect in lysine and proline hydroxylation. Okay, now sixth one is the chondrodysplasia. Chondrodysplasia, it is it results in the dwarfism. It is due to mutation in gene coding for the type 2 collagen. The next disease which is related with this collagen synthesis, or with the related with the collagen, is epidermolysis bullosa. Epidermolysis bullosa. Okay, easy rupture of the skin and blister formation with minor trauma in the epidermolysis bullosa. It is due to a defective gene for collagen 7. So these are the various disorders related with the collagen synthesis in extracellular matrix, related with the collagen in the extracellular matrix. Now coming to the second component of extracellular matrix, that is elastin. Second component is elastin. Elastin, it is present in elastic tissues and confers elasticity and recoil. It confers elasticity and recoil. Elastin, it confers elasticity and recoil of lung, large vessels, for example aorta. Okay, vessels and lung vessels and tendons. Okay, elastin, it is formed from proelastin. It is having simple structure, no triple helix is there, no glycine XY repeat is there, only hydroxylation of proline occurs in post-translational modification, no hydroxylation of lysine, and it is a simple structure responsible for elasticity and recoils of various tissues. Okay, elastin. Now, what are the various disorders which are related with the elastin? The first one is the Williams syndrome. Okay, this is the disease related with the elastin, defective gene for elastin. Williams syndrome, it results in the formation of supravalvular aortic stenosis. Supravalvular aortic stenosis is there in this syndrome, Williams syndrome. Then second disease which is related with this is scleroderma. Scleroderma, In this scleroderma, there is increased elastin. Third one is the pulmonary emphysema. Emphysema, there is decreased elastin or increased degradation of elastin found in the emphysema. And fourth one is the aging. Aging, decreased levels of elastin found in the older age. Okay, so these are the four conditions which are related with the elastin. Now next one is the fibrillin. It is important, fibrillin. Okay, it is present in periosteum, aorta, defective gene for fibrillin 1, defective gene for fibrillin 1 lead to the Marfan's syndrome. Marfan's syndrome. It is characterized by long digits. Marfan syndrome characterized by tall stature, long digits. Then ectopia lentis, as there is, it is present in eyes. It results in subluxation of lens. Okay, that is known as ectopia lentis. And CVS malformation because of dilatation of aorta. Okay, fibrillin. So these are the three components, fibrous component or structural components of extracellular matrix: collagen, elastin and fibrillin. Now, what are the various disorders related with these fibrous or structural proteins? So in collagen, osteogenesis imperfecta. Second one is the Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. Then Alport syndrome, Menkes disease, scurvy, epidermolysis bullosa. These are the various conditions related with collagen. Then with elastin, Williams syndrome. Then scleroderma, emphysema and aging. Fibrillin, it is associated with Marfan's syndrome. Marfan's syndrome, it is due to defective gene for fibrillin 1. Okay, so these are the fibrous structural proteins. Now coming to the specialized glycoproteins. Glycoprotein means carbohydrate plus protein. What are the specialized glycoproteins present in extracellular matrix? The first one is the fibronectin. Fibronectin. And second one is the laminin. Okay. Fibronectin, it is responsible for cell adhesion and cell migration. Cell adhesion and migration. It is responsible for, it is a glycoprotein, it is a large glycoprotein, it is responsible for cell adhesion and migration. It is responsible for connection between cell and extracellular matrix. And if there is deficiency of fibronectin, which is found in tumor cells, there is decrease in fibronectin level. That's why there is loss of cell adhesion. Due to decrease in fibronectin level, there is loss of cell adhesion and tumor cell will metastasis. The metastasis will occur due to loss of cell adhesion due to decrease in the fibronectin level. So it is related with the tumor cells and metastasis. It is fibronectin. Laminin, it is present in lamina of basement membrane. Lamina of basement membrane. Laminin. Okay, it is lamina of basement membrane and it is responsible for glomerular filtration. Glomerular filtration. Okay, due to this thick glomerular membrane, it is responsible for charge selective glomerular permeability. It is particularly important in case of albumin. mainly it is negatively charged heparan sulfate, due to which albumin in normal cases does not crosses the this filtration barrier. Okay, but whenever there is injury to this glomerular basement membrane, there is loss of this charge occurs, and this low molecular weight albumin will filter through this membrane. Okay, so this is particularly important in glomerulonephritis and nephrotic syndrome. So laminin, so these are the two specialized glycoproteins present in extracellular matrix. Now the proteoglycans means it is made up of core protein. Okay, proteoglycans. It is made up of, this is the structure which is given. Okay, so this is a core protein. So this is structure of proteoglycan. This is a core protein, and these are the glycosaminoglycan, keratin sulfate, dermatan sulfate, etc., chondroitin sulfate. Okay, so in proteoglycans, it is principally made up of glycosaminoglycans, and the concentration is up to 95%. Okay, so various glycosaminoglycans are there in the proteoglycans. It may be hyaluronic acid, keratin sulfate, chondroitin sulfate, dermatan sulfate, heparan sulfate, heparin. These are the various glycosaminoglycan. Hyaluronic acid, it is present in synovial fluid and vitreous humor of the eye. Then it acts as a shock absorbent and lubricant. Hyaluronic acid, shock absorbent and lubricant. Okay, then keratin sulfate, it is present in the cornea. It is responsible for corneal transparency. Chondroitin sulfate, it is present in the cartilage. Then dermatan sulfate, it is present in skin, and it has wide distribution. Then heparan sulfate, it is present in glomerular basement membrane. And responsible for charge selective glomerular filtration. Heparin, it is an anticoagulant. It is present in lung liver. Heparin, it is an anticoagulant. So these are the various glycosaminoglycans involved in the formation of proteoglycans. Various proteoglycans are agrican. We already discussed the name. The agrican is common. Then these are the various glycosaminoglycans involved in the formation of proteoglycans. They form the ground substance. They act as a shock absorbent. They act as lubricants. They are responsible for the formation of various tissues. They give shape and strength to the various tissues. Okay, so these are the various glycosaminoglycan. Now what are the various disorders related with this glycosaminoglycan and proteoglycans? The disorders, they are known as mucopolysaccharidosis. Okay, what are the general features of mucopolysaccharidosis? Okay, skeletal deformities in mucopolysaccharidosis. Then coarse facies, facial appearance is coarse, that is known as. Then organomegaly, hepatosplenomegaly is there, organomegaly. Then mental retardation, mental retardation. So these are the different features. Then there is involvement of vision and involvement of means vision and deafness, blindness and deafness is there. There is involvement, corneal involvement is also there, retinal involvement is also there, and there is deafness in the mucopolysaccharidosis. So these are the typical symptoms of mucopolysaccharidosis. Various disorders are there. The name of disorders are Hurler syndrome is the first. Hurler syndrome. Second one is the Hunter syndrome. Third one is the Sanfilippo. Four types A, B, C, and D. Then fourth one is the Marcio syndrome, that is A and B. Then Rotox T E O U X Morotex Lamy and Sly syndrome. These are the various disorders included in the mucopolysaccharidosis, and these are the classical features of mucopolysaccharidosis. The functions of discussed the functions of various glycosaminoglycans. These proteoglycans, they help in the formation of ground substance of connective tissues, or help in the formation of ground substance, or help in the formation of extracellular matrix, and has lot of functions. Okay, important ones are, they are responsible for formation of heart walls, blood vessels, give elasticities to the skin. They are responsible for cell adhesion and migration. Then they are responsible for the charge selective glomerular permeability. They are shock absorbent, etc. So this is all about extracellular matrix. So keep watching, and thank you.